Thank you, Charlie. The next lady I'm going to introduce is a lady I've known since I've been involved in politics, and she's worked very, very hard to get where she is today, and she has a tough fight against her in the fall. So we all need to keep her in our prayers, certainly, but she's a hard worker. She's worked in the legislature, both the House and the Senate, and we certainly do appreciate her in Androscoggin County, Senator Lois Stormell.
For all your dedication and hard work on behalf of Republicans in Androscoggin County and all across our state. And I want to thank each and every one of you in this room. And what a wonderful event this is, isn't it? So, and I want to thank you for all you do for the Republicans. I'm honored tonight to introduce my very good friend, Senate President Kevin Ray, Republican candidate for Maine's 2nd Congressional District seat in the U.S. House of Representatives. It's exciting to know that we have a candidate who can return this seat to the GOP column this year. Isn't that right? In 2002, never having held elective office, Kevin Ray came very, very close to winning this seat against longtime politician Mike Lucia, and in fact, holds the record for winning the highest vote percentage of any GOP candidate for the seat in the past 20 years. 10 years later, Kevin is serving his fourth term in the Maine Senate, representing Washington County and parts of Hancock, Penobscot counties. He has been re-elected by wide margins, last time with over 71% of the vote. In 2010, after 2 years as Senate Republican leader, Kevin led Republicans to an historic majority in the Maine Senate, where we now have 19 GOP senators, more than any time in the past 3 decades. Following that election, Kevin was unanimously elected as Senate President, and it has been my pleasure to work closely with him in that capacity. I've seen Kevin work to promote fiscal responsibility, leading by example in reducing spending on his own staff budget by 20%, and leading a process that produced over $8 million in savings in the legislative budget, a 14% cut. Early in his term, Senate President Ray established a constructive and respectful tone in the Senate that has helped make the first Republican legislature in 4 decades the most productive and successful legislature in recent memory. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my friend and our next Congressman, Kevin Ray.
Thank you very much. I have to say it is wonderful to be back in Androscoggin County and to be with all of you for this celebration of our first Republican president and the ideals that this party has adhered to since its founding back before the Civil War. You know, when I was sitting there and Professor Doug Hodgkin was introduced, and he came up here and he started telling us a little bit about the history of the party, and particularly with Androscoggin County, I found myself sitting up really straight. I got out my pen and started to take notes, because I had a flashback. 30 years ago, he was my professor. And for 4 years, he was my advisor. And he helped me to get through 4 years of college with my Republican ideals intact. So, I want to thank Senator Snovello for that wonderful introduction, and it is such a pleasure and an honor to serve in the Maine Senate with Lois Snovello and Garrett Mason, both of whom do Androscoggin County proud in the Maine Senate every single day. And likewise with the illustrious group of representatives that were acknowledged earlier. I can tell you, Androscoggin County, it certainly did its part in helping us turn things around in Augusta, and we're very grateful to you for sending so many quality, outstanding Republican legislators to Augusta. All of them a part of the historic new direction that this state is taking with the leadership of our very able governor, Paul LePage. It's also wonderful to be here in a community, communities that have made history locally, as has been mentioned here this evening, with the elections of Mayor McDonald and Mayor Labonte. Who would have thought that any of us would live to see the day that Lewiston and Auburn both have Republican mayors and that the Lewiston City Council has a Republican majority. God bless you. Of course, as we gather here this evening, we gather against the backdrop of a quiet time on the Maine political scene. Not much going on. Same old, same old. Wow, has this ever been a week to remember? What an amazing series of events. Nothing short of extraordinary. The political earthquake of Olympia Snow's announcement over 72 hours ago that she would be retiring after such an amazing career representing our state in Washington. And it was an earthquake, and we're now seeing reverberate across the state the political aftershocks. As we have seen in the span of 72 hours, the launching of a number of campaigns, the demise of a few other campaigns. And certainly from my perspective, it's been an incredible few hours. Many of you know that as a high school student at Shedd Memorial High School up in Eastport, I read in the Maine Sunday Telegram on this particular Sunday that there was speculation that our current congressman at the time, Bill Cohen, may take on Senator Hathaway. He may run for the United States Senate. And if he did that, what would happen to his seat? And it listed two or three potential candidates. And one of them was your state senator here from Androscoggin County, Olympia Snow. And so, for whatever reason, at the time I was 15, I sat down and I wrote a letter. I wrote a letter to several of people that day, but one of them was Olympia Snow. And I told her that, gee, I really liked politics, but I would have to understand her position on some key issues. And I asked her how she felt on some key issues of the day, put that letter in the mail, and lo and behold, a couple of weeks later, I received in the mail a four-page handwritten letter from Olympia Snow, who took the time to pay attention to a kid that she didn't know, who lived in the other end of the state, and she answered every one of my questions with specificity. I was amazed that she would respect my letter that much. And a few weeks after that, my phone rang one night. And of course, you know, I'm 15, 16 years old. And my mother said, there's a phone call for you. And I said, is it a guy or a girl? And she said, it's a female. So I went upstairs to take the call. And much to my amazement, it was Olympia Snow. And she told me she was coming to Washington County and that she wanted to meet me. And that meeting began a journey for me, which was life-changing. And I had the opportunity, and before I was old enough to vote, I was her county chairman in Washington County, and I was representing her at the local Republican meetings. And went on to spend, believe it or not, after Professor Hodgkin's tutelage at Bates, went to work for Olympia. I thought I'd do it for a year or two, and I had 17 and a half years working for this remarkable lady. In 11 of those years, I ran her offices here in Maine, in Auburn, in Bangor, and Presque Isle. And then when she was elected to the Senate in 94, she asked me to go down with her. And I had the honor and privilege of serving as her chief of staff of the United States Senate on Capitol Hill for 6.5 years. And you can only imagine, probably with the exception of Georgia Chalmers, her beloved cousin, who really is really more like a sister. Today, attending her press conference was a very emotional journey for me, as I had been there from the beginning, had the opportunity to work with her for so long, and then to see her today bid farewell to the office that she's held with such distinction. It really hit me. It's been quite a day. But I have to say, I am so blessed and so grateful to have had the opportunity that I have had, and to know that I have the opportunity this year to work to carry on the fight and to work to continue the legacy that she has brought to Maine of just stellar public service and working for the people and keeping Maine people in mind first and foremost. I am determined, as I stand here before you tonight, that we are going to return the 2nd Congressional District seat to the Republican column in the Senate. These are extraordinary times, and there is so much at stake for the future of this country. And you hear this every 2 years, but in our time, it's true as never before. It has never been a clearer choice for the direction of this country. Is America going to remain the nation that we know and love, where individual initiative, individual responsibility, and the rights of individuals are preeminent over the power of the government? Or will we continue down the very dangerous path that Barack Obama is leading this nation? I submit to you that while we hear it every 2 years, this is the most pivotal election in the history of our country, where literally the foundation of our country is at stake. Never before have we had an administration who is working to move our country in such a shocking departure from all of our traditions and what has made this country great. Never before have the stakes been higher. Look at the issues we face. A reckless spending spree embraced by my opponent, calls himself a blue dog, but somebody said today, he's a blue dog with no teeth. He's a blue dog who only barks. Because he votes with Nancy Pelosi and his party leadership 87% of the time. Now, most blue dogs hover around 50%, maybe 60. Congressman Michaud is 87%. He's no blue dog.